On today's episode of Montage, we're exploring the ins and outs of the Monterey Peninsula. We start off getting schooled in the house of rock that is vintage guitar shop, Rumble Seat Music, and revving our engines at the annual Pebble Beach Concours d'Elegance. Later, we'll check out one of Judy Profeta's luxury home listings in the majestic Santa Lucia Preserve. After, we'll sit down with Carmel Valley native Jimmy Panetta and hear his interesting past and current projects around the Monterey County. And finish up on the stunning cliffside and underwater world of Point Lobos. Stay right here. It's all coming up on today's episode of Montage. Rock and roll music. The guitar is for many as iconic an American symbol as the Stars and Stripes or apple pie. Enter Elliot Michael, a well-schooled musician. He's become a renowned collector, curator of fine instruments, and the first person many top artists look to when they are in need of a special guitar. Today, we're lucky enough to get the full story on some of these beauties as we explore Rumble Seat Music.
When I first started the store, I was trying to come up with a name, and you know, you come up with Michael's Music, this, that, you know, just nothing sounded right. I like old cars, so I was thinking like an old Rumble Seat, and like I was married to this woman, you know, when I first started. So I said to her, "What do you think about the name?" She said, "I hate it." I went, "Perfect." So I kept it. A lot of people that I've been dealing with for a long time have collections, and they'll call us and they want to sell a couple of their guitars, or original owners will call us because they've heard about us and we'll end up buying guitars from them. Rumble Seat is a special place because people can actually come in from off the streets and be able to look around and see like all these really beautiful high-end guitars and actually play them, which is definitely different than most stores that I've, you know, experienced. I love it when people, you know, come in and sit down and play like a 59 Les Paul and just go, "Wow, this is the best guitar I've ever played." And it's just the fact that sometimes we'll have kids who are like 12 years old, 10-year-old kids come in and go, and they'll point to the 59 Les Paul and they go, "Is that the same guitar that Jimmy Page plays and that Jeff Beck played and all those people?" And we'll say, "Yeah," and then we give them the guitar to play, and you can see the smile on their face. They're just really happy, you know, they actually play the guitar like that. Most of the rock stars I know that deal with us are just really great people, really easy to deal with, and they know what they want. So it's just a matter of them calling us and us shipping them guitars. Or sometimes, well, last year Johnny Depp came into a store in Albuquerque and ended up buying a bunch of guitars and bought a couple of guitars for the guys in Aerosmith. So it's just easy to deal with. The store in New York is a bigger store. It's two floors. A very cool old building. It's a great store. The store in Carmel, I came out here just to visit a friend and ended up staying here and then opened a store. And we opened up more of a boutique-y, smaller store here.
Good friend Joe Bonamassa has been known to make an appearance in Rumble Seat.
I've known Joe since he was 12, and we've always been friends, and I knew his father, and we used to do guitar shows together and hang out together a lot. Now Joe has become the virtuoso he is. So Joe and I go back 25, you know, something like that, years now. We deal with the Rolling Stones, we deal with U2, we deal with Rush is another band we deal with. Well, Joe Bonamassa, like I said before, Brian Setzer is a really good friend of mine. Again, the list goes on. There's a lot of people that we deal with. We have something for almost every collector and player. You know, there's every level of expensive guitars to down to reasonable price guitars.
If you're looking for the cream of the crop, follow Elliot down the hall to what was once a bank vault.
Every guitar that's high end goes into the vault at nighttime and comes back out in the morning.
Should your axe fall on dark days, it's a full service shop. Elliot and his mates can perform guitar and equipment maintenance and repairs of any kind. The former owners of these instruments reads like a who's who of music legends past and present. Take a strum through Elliot's inventory and you inevitably end up with pieces of rock history in your hands.
Purple Marshall is a limited edition Jimi Hendrix edition. A friend of mine in Italy had the largest collection of Marshall amps. And what I did is I went over there a few years ago and bought every Marshall he had. So we had the largest Marshall collection around. So that's one of the ones I've kept. That's one of my favorites. That's the late 60s Marshall stack, which is the ultimate amplifier to me. You know, it's what everybody used back in the late 60s, the 70s, and still using them now.
Connecting musicians from all corners of the globe, Elliot unites the creative community through his passion for these instruments and their musical potential.
If you have a guitar that's all original, that's the best way to keep it, whether it's in great condition, bad condition, just always keep it original, because if you do any changes, it's like anything that's collectible, it brings the value down. So if people take a guitar because it's got a scratch, they'll have it refinished. And what that'll do is it can bring the price down half what it's valued at. So the best thing to do if you have a guitar and it's a vintage guitar that you really care about, just let it be, and it's keep it original. A lot of guitar players are striving to get a 59 Les Paul. The problem is they are expensive and they are hard to find. You know, all original ones are really hard to find because they've been around for so long, people have done changes to them, and you just never know until you have it in your hands if it's original or not. If you've ever tried one, you'd understand it. If you haven't, you know, we'd love to come by and try one.
Thanks to Elliot and Rumble Seat Music, you can visit these rare gems today. And if the chemistry and price is right, start your own musical adventure.
A competition of elegance, Pebble Beach's Concours d'Elegance puts the art of motoring on display like nowhere else in the world. Hosted on the 18th hole of the fabulous Pebble Beach Golf Course, this is not just any car show. Each year, it attracts throngs of collectors and enthusiasts excited to see the most stunning automotive designs of ages past and get a peek at the future of motoring through the vast exhibition of concept cars on hand. Down the road in Monterey, we find the Mecum Auction. Like most that take place here, is packed with eager collectors looking to make a bid on their dream car and equally eager onlookers waiting to see just how big a check might be needed to park one of these beauties in the garage. At the Mecum Auctions, you can admire the historic beauty of these classic cars and even check out the modern look, like this Mercedes McLaren. The Concours is as much a social event as a competition, featuring art exhibitions and presentations by today's leading car designers and manufacturers. Since the beginning, the Concours has created eye-catching posters featuring the sleek and sexy machines of yesteryear. Walking among such beauty, it becomes difficult to decide what is more deserving of one's gaze, the cars or the landscape. Nestled into some of the most beautiful seascapes in North America, Pebble Beach is a jewel unto itself. Not far away, you might take in the historic sites of Monterey and Pacific Grove, or visit the rugged coastline that pulls visitors down the coast towards Big Sur. The rubber meets the road in a special way around the Monterey Peninsula. There's no better setting than this in which to enjoy your four-wheeled passion. The ultimate melding of art and technology, these cars, like their owners and drivers, symbolize the true spirit of innovation. Whether American muscle cars or European roadsters whet your appetite, search the Concours and you're sure to stumble upon your own dream machine.
Special thanks to all our sponsors who help make Montage possible. Monterey County District Attorney, United States Navy Veteran, Rancho Cielo Board Director, Central Coast Veterans Cemetery Foundation, the list goes on. Jimmy Panetta is everywhere. We're meeting with this intrepid mover and shaker and how he is affecting others around the Monterey County.
You know, growing up in the household that I did, whatever you did, you had to work hard. And so what I realized growing up is that the harder I worked at sports, the better I got, just like anything. And so it was a real lesson in developing my work ethic. After law school, I was fortunate enough to get a summer clerkship with Alameda in between my second and third year. Going into that office, you know that there are certain ethics that you have to have as a prosecutor when you are dealing with individuals, dealing with their lives, and prosecuting these people and dealing with victims and understanding that it's about, not necessarily about the law, but about the people affected by the law in your role as a prosecutor. So, and that was pretty much the attitude throughout the office. So you dealt with a lot of good people. It's a great legal community up there. And you really learned how to try cases, get on top of that, do it the right way. Because as, you know, People v. Hill says, 1998 Supreme Court case, prosecutors are upheld to a higher standard than other attorneys. And they reinforce that at that DA's office.
After time in Alameda, Jimmy considered a new path with the U.S. Navy.
There had always been a part of me that wanted to join the service, serve our country. Got to a point where I figured, well, I better do this now before it gets too late and I regret not doing it. So I joined the U.S. Navy Reserve. And I was engaged at the time, so I talked to Carrie, and she was fine with it, being from the Midwest and being the patriotic citizen and coming from the patriotic family that she does. She was fine with it. And so I was a weekend warrior, which it was fine. I enjoyed wearing the uniform, but I also realized that there were other people abroad during this time that were also wearing the uniform, and they were fighting and dying. And that is something that I felt I couldn't just wear this uniform if they're doing that same thing. And so I decided to go forward. I look at my time in the military, in the U.S. Navy, just like I do raising children, in the sense that you forget the bad stuff, and you only, when you look back and you think back about it, all you think about is the good stuff. And so it was one of the proudest things that I've ever done.
Now the Monterey County District Attorney, Jimmy dedicates his time helping underprivileged young adults in Salinas.
Rancho Cielo, that's helping out underserved youth that didn't have the opportunities that I did. And so I am fortunate to be a part not only of that organization, but of that board of directors. You have some amazing, dynamic individuals on that board, starting with its founder, John Phillips, who's now a supervisor. And what they do to create this campus, this place where our underserved youth can go and kind of get out of the environment that was keeping them down and allow them to grow being here on the campus at Rancho Cielo, be it through the German Culinary Academy where they get their GED and learn how to cook and serve in restaurants so that hopefully they can get a job once they graduate, to their Silver Star program, which gets them the GED, to their Youth Corps program, which is a vocational school, which hopefully gives them the school necessary to get a job, as well as their GED. So it's basically giving kids a chance that they didn't have in the community where they grew up.
And if you're wondering what's next for Jimmy.
In the future, you know, I'm here because I wanted to be home. I was fortunate enough to have a sense of belonging. Fortunate enough to have a sense of service. And so right now I'm enjoying my position as a prosecutor in a court of law representing the people of Monterey County. If something opens up in the future where I can continue to serve the people of this area, then I will seriously consider it. But for now, I'm enjoying representing the people in the court of law in Monterey County, and I'm enjoying being on the boards that I'm on, and enjoying being able to get things done locally, such as working on the funding for the Veterans Cemetery, where Mayor Burnett and I put together a capital campaign where we were able to help out the state at the request of Senator Bill Monning and Congressman Sam Farr get this money together and make sure that local people stepped up and donated, which they were more than willing to do once they knew about the cemetery, the Veterans Cemetery. So that's kind of what I'm enjoying doing right now. And if something comes along in the future where I can continue to serve this area, I'll do it.
Montage is the premier luxury lifestyle program showcasing inspirational personalities, unparalleled destinations, high-end goods, and philanthropic causes. Join us every Saturday at 7 p.m. on KSBW as we venture off in Northern California to discover unique topics and stories. If you are interested in becoming a sponsor or having your story in Montage TV, go to our website at montagechannel.com.
Spend a few moments on the rocky coastline or the winding trails of Point Lobos, and it quickly becomes clear how it earned the title Crown Jewel of the California Park System. Squeezed into this relatively small area is an astounding amount of diversity. Point Lobos awakens the senses with the salty spray of crashing waves, fields of billowing wildflowers, and ancient twisting trees. Human activity around Point Lobos over the past 200 years has been almost as diverse as the variety of plant and animal life we find here today. The area was once base camp for abalone harvesters. Exploring today, we often find the luminous shell fragments so sought after in days gone by. Chinese immigrants settled here, creating villages in the 1850s and quickly becoming the area's most intrepid abalone fishermen. We can step into a piece of history by visiting the Whaler's Cabin Museum. The structure was built by those early Chinese settlers and now houses artifacts from the area and chronicles its colourful past. Portuguese fishermen created the Carmel Bay Whaling Company and hunted the mammoth creatures for over 20 years in the late 1800s. We can also view the remnants of their labour at the Whaler's Cabin Museum. Point Lobos also served in the mid to late 1800s as a coal mining site. Ore carts once rolled the raw material down a path, now what is now Highway 1. Trading harpoons and nets for radar equipment and anti-aircraft guns, Point Lobos became part of the United States Army's Coastal Defense Squad. Soldiers here watched for enemy ships on the horizon and trained for amphibious landings on the coastline. When the area's coal mining activities dried up, 1,000 lots were sold and developed into what became known as Carmelito. After purchasing some of the land in the late 1890s, Alexander Allen became convinced that the area's natural beauty needed to be conserved. He continued to acquire land and became devoted to its preservation. In 1933, the state of California purchased much of the land from the Allen family and dedicated 15 acres of beautiful cypress-covered land to its ultimate admirer. Today, its unique ecological properties have earned it a protected status. It was the nation's first marine sanctuary and is, to date, its largest. The natural beauty of Point Lobos has always attracted and inspired artists. Through the years, dozens of films have used the area to dramatic effect. Multitudes of land and sea animals call Point Lobos home. Below the surface of the crashing sea lies a whole different world of plants and animals. The amount of diversity is astounding, from its giant kelp forest to the otters that call it home. The underwater experience here is beyond description. Divers come from far and wide to explore the waters here at the nation's first underwater reserve. But you don't have to suit up and dive in to get an idea of what's under the water. This 3D model of the reserve enables everyone to take the plunge. Truly a living monument, the park is at once a calming and exhilarating experience. Winter, spring, summer, and fall, Point Lobos holds unique treasures waiting to be discovered.
Special thanks to all our sponsors who help make Montage possible.